This is Picture in a Picture class. We're going to draw a picture of this humpback whale and then fill it in with another picture of some waves, some mountains, and a nice night sky. I'm going to start with pencil to sketch out my picture. You probably want your paper sideways if it has a long edge and a short edge. I'll try to get these both on camera. Maybe zoom out a little bit. What we're going to look at first is how this kind of looks like a soup spoon. If we take off all the fins, we basically got a Chinese style soup spoon. So we are going to go ahead and make this long flat side first, about half of the paper. Leave a little bit of room for the tail on the other side. Then we're going to make a very short line for the tip of the mouth here. And just for right now, we're just going to make this a curve. That's going to fill up most of the paper. Notice I'm not doing tiny little lines with my fingers. I'm taking my whole arm off of the table so I can use my shoulder to make great big curves. Drawing lots and lots of lines for lots and lots of options, and just get rid of the ones that you don't like as much. Draw nice and lightly. We're going to be erasing these later anyway. And this curve that we've just drawn is going to flip around and go the other way. So I'm going to have a curve over here, flip the other way, and I'm going to smooth it back into the curve that I already have. I'm cutting off a little bit of extra down there. That's okay. We'll just get my eraser back out and edit that. This is why we start in pencil, so we can change things as we go. In fact, I might move my whale's nose a little closer to the paper on this side. And I can move the tail a little bit away from the edge on this side. So keep working on your shape, move it around on the paper if you need to. Oh, I think a light bulb is going out in my lamp, so you might see some lighting changes. So we're looking for this little curve for the tail, big curve for the body and the under part of the mouth. Flat on top, and then we're going to go ahead and connect the entire shape. And next we'll draw the tail, the fluke. I'm sure some of you already know that's how you can identify one whale from another. They all have different tails. That's good news for us. That means you don't have to copy mine exactly. Just drawn one side, looks a little bit like a leaf shape. And then the other side, a skinnier leaf shape. Or if you happen to draw lots of mermaids, it'll be similar to that too. And then we've got these great big flippers that are a little bit similar to the sea turtle ones that we drew last week. So somewhere in the middle of your big curve here, we're going to have a line that goes pretty much down. That's the front part here, and then to the back. We'll do a tight little turn for that tip. And then make it get thicker as it goes back to the body. And you can erase the inside. Welcome, iPad.
I'm not iPad, I'm Lucy.
Oh, Fussy! Okay, I will change your name for you. And then the last fin on the other side, we can only see a little bit of the tip. And we're going to polish up the shape a little bit. You can see there's a very, very subtle reverse curve right at the front of the lower jaw here. So I'm going to just shave off, carve away, make that thinner, erase the ones I don't need. So we get a little bit more of a point happening at the tip. My whale's nose is too short. I'm gonna make it a touch longer. And then on the top of the head, it's not exactly flat. There's a small incline. So I'm just going to add a very, very, very slight triangle point on the top. You can see I have a short line on one side and then a long line on the other side. Mine's probably a little too bumpy. We want to keep it subtle. So they are called humpback whales, not humphead whales, right? And humpback whales have dorsal fins. I'm not sure why this one doesn't, but they do. So I'm going to add a dorsal fin back here. Thank you. And one of the differences between whale flippers or side fins and the turtle flippers is the turtle, we put bumps on the back, right? But this time for this whale, we're going to put the bumps on the front. So I'm going to add a couple of little bumps. Not a whole bunch, not a big deal, just a little bit to make one side different than the other. And we'll draw a couple of those little bumps on the fluke as well. And then we're going to work on all of these lines on the lower jaw of our humpback whale. Maybe you guys have seen a couple of nature shows where the humpback whales scoop up all that ocean water to catch this tiny little sea shrimp. So I want a thin part on top and a thicker part on the bottom. And you can plot out your lines right now, or you can wait until we get to pen. We're just going to have some lines follow the same outward contour, same kind of curves. And this whale's eye, and actually all whales' eyes are a little bit lower than you might expect. So we have to wait until we get below this curve of the mouth, and we'll put the eye down here. I'm just going to make a little oval and put a little wrinkle. You can think of it like an eyebrow right above it. And don't forget, we're going to leave a tiny little white spot for the shine. You might want to draw that out so you don't forget. Personally, I'm not a fan of the lines on the tail. I think it looks too fish-like. That's my personal opinion. If you're like, ooh, I really like the stripes on the tail because they kind of match the stripes on the lower part of the jaw, then go for it. You can put it in. Maybe your personal opinion is it looks good. And I think we are ready to ink this. If you happen to have a kneading eraser, now would be a good time to take it out and get rid of some of the extra pencil. If you don't have one of these, that's okay. You can skip this step. It's not super important. It just helps the ink stick to the paper a little bit easier. But if you don't do it, it's okay. All is not lost. I'm just trying to make my life a little easier. You can use whatever kind of felt tip pen you happen to have. You might have a writing pen like this one. It's just a regular old writing pen. You might have a couple of those inking pens that you see at like Michael's and stuff. Whatever pen you got, that's the one to use. I'm going to use a little bit thicker marker for the outline. And remember the tips when we are doing our outline. Turn your paper to where it's the most comfortable so you can make your line easier. As much as you can, try to keep your arm off the table so that you'll remember to use your whole arm and not just your fingers, not just your wrist. Whales and other animals that have these big, long, sweeping lines, those can be tough. So what happens if you get like halfway through and you go, oh no, what am I going to do? I stopped right in the middle of that line. How am I going to continue it? What not to do? I'm not going to do it because it's going to ruin my drawing. Let me get some scrap paper. If you have a line that's incomplete and you put your pen down to keep it going, you get a dot. And now everybody knows you couldn't finish that line. So if you have a line that's incomplete, what I like to do is I like to be like a plane coming down for a landing. So I'm already moving and then I keep drawing my line. Then I can smooth it out and go over as many times as I need to. And I don't have that dot that happens from sticking my pen down first. So here on this line, I'm gonna position it to where I'm comfortable. I'm gonna keep my pen moving, touchdown, but I'm already moving. And there might be a little difference. That's where you take your skinny pen and you just smooth out that little bit. And there you go. You can hardly tell that I had to do that line in two passes. I'm switching to my skinnier pen for the inside details. I'm going to pause here until 4:25. So you still have 4 more minutes to work on your outlining, your inking, and make sure that that ink is dry before you bring in an eraser and finish erasing your pencil lines.
Smells good.
Ooh, you got like a scented one? Smells like licorice? Here's a little close-up. Let me sharpen the focus. Still 2 more minutes before we move on. One more minute. All right, next I'm going to put in my water line. There's some water on the bottom of the whale there. I'm going to grab my marker, and the water level is just above the eye. I'm just going to pick a spot. It doesn't have to be completely straight. I just want to pick where my water line is. If you feel more comfortable doing it in pencil first, go ahead and do that. And we're going to add some waves into this water. Let me get a little closer here so we can see. We're going to start with these shapes that look a little bit like worms or a little bit like, I don't know what else, they look like worms to me. But they're the foamy part of the wave.
It looks like snakes also.
Oh, okay. That's true, this middle one especially, huh? It looks like that's an eye and that's a
foam. And it also looks like an eel.
Eel, snakes, all kinds of shapes like that. That's the foamy part of the wave, the white part. So let's go ahead and draw this one on the bottom that's coming right out of the flipper. So we're going to go straight across for a little bit. And make a little curve down like a slide. I'm starting on the bottom edge here, going straight across and then down. And then it gets a little bumpy. So we're just going to make bump, bump, bump. We're going to come back around. A couple more bumps maybe. And then we'll make a curve up. And go right back into the flipper. Then to show the water that is coming up to that foam, we're going to start at the top and flick downward. Whoops. Make sure I'm on camera. Flick downward. We're going to do that whole process again with the middle wave. Actually, no, let's do the top wave and then we'll know how much space we have in the middle. So I'm going to do this big, long one on top that's very close to my line. Long. Bump. Bubble, bubble, bubble. Bubble, bubble, bubble. Come back around. And you can see on this bigger one, those lines that are curving down from the wave. So that's the water swelling up into that crest of a wave. If all this is too hard, of course, you can do traditional type water just like this, right? Everybody knows how to do that kind of water. And now I can do my last wave right in the middle. But if these waves were having a race, this one is in the lead. It's on the left side. So I'm going to go across, bump, and make sure that my little bumps go more to the left, almost touch the edge of my whale. And again, I'll put in my water lines. And the rest of the water is going to be lots and lots of horizontal lines just sketched in here and there. No real pattern, so I'm just picking sometimes two little lines, sometimes a long line, trying to make them look a little bit different from one another. And we're going to fill up this whole part of the whale until we get to the waterline. Yep, these lines are going to take a long time, so we'll probably spend until 4:35, 4:36. Give you a whole 5 minutes, which I know doesn't seem like a long time, but when you're drawing just line, you can draw a lot of lines in 5 minutes. And again, you don't have to copy me exactly. We're just putting in some lines. I try to vary it up. So I'm thinking long, short, maybe medium, long, short over here, short over there. Another long one. Still another 3 minutes to fill up your water. Still another 2 more minutes, so just work away, filling up the space. If you're already done, get a drink of water. Stretch your fingers. Just 1 more minute and then we'll keep going. Alrighty, we're going to keep on going and we're going to go ahead and draw in the moon. You might want to do this with a pencil first in case you want to change your moon. So I'll do that with you just so that you can see how it goes. I think it's also a little easier to draw a moon if I can draw the whole circle. And then draw another circle inside of that, touching the edge, so I can get a nice crescent moon after I erase this line here. And you can keep using your pencil if you want. I'm going to use my pen and we're going to start drawing in some of these mountains. We've got kind of a short one on the end here, right underneath the moon. I don't have room underneath my moon, but I can put it right next to my moon. Another mountain, and another mountain. Maybe these are volcanoes on islands far away. Oh goodness, I must have one pen that smears. Yep, it's on my hand too. I think it's this pen. I'm gonna stop recommending this pen. This pen smears, or maybe it's my paper. Could be my paper too. It's a little slick. After you draw in those mountains, we're going to start drawing a couple little circles for stars. You might have one of those white gel pens that you can draw stars over black ink, but I'm gonna pretend I don't have that today, and I'm going to start drawing my stars, and I'm going to make them pretty big, almost like I'm drawing snow instead, because I can always color more black around them to make them smaller, but I can't make them bigger. And I'll fill up the sky with stars that kind of look like snow at the moment. If you want to, every once in a while, you can do an actual star shape. Or you can do a little twinkle shape. Remember to change the sizes. So we have small ones, big ones. I don't want it to look like polka dots of just the same circle over and over. Tell yourself big, medium, small, and another medium, and a big, and a small, and another small. I like to put my stars in little groups or little families, so that I have some spaces with no stars and then some spaces with a little group of stars. But I'm not going to draw any stars inside this part of the moon because that's just a shadow. It's not that there's no moon there. It's just that there's a shadow, so we can't see that part of the moon being lit up. So then we're gonna go ahead and keep filling in all the way to the tip of the tail. Different size stars. And one important line that we're going to keep white is right at the tip of the mouth here. We've got this very skinny white line. So over here, I'm going to leave a little bit of white. Let me zoom in so you can see that better. So I added this line on top so that after I start filling this part in, there's going to be that white stripe to show where the whale's mouth opens. You can see it on the tip here. This is where we usually get out our thick markers so that we can color this in more quickly. If you don't have a thick marker, you can of course still do it with a thin marker. You just need a little more patience. Be a little slower. So for maybe about 5 minutes, go ahead and fill in your sky with black and stars. And then we'll do some texture on the mountains together after that. So on your own until about 4:50, 4:49, something like that. Hello.
Oh wow, you know what, the thing just, when I logged in, it gave me like a thing that said, a warning that said, hey, you, this is being recorded. By joining, you are consenting to be recorded, which is very nice, in my opinion.
Yeah, it's nice to know when there's a camera on.
Yeah, I really wish that it had that the first time I logged in. Oh well.
Looks like they've got it running now. Just about 3 more minutes. As you can see, I'm not even done filling in my sky, but filling in black is the easy part that you can always do on your own time. So we'll spend more class time on the harder stuff together. Just one more minute on your sky, and then we'll go ahead and do the mountains. Alrighty, we're going to do a little bit of stippling on our mountains since they're so tiny, it won't take too long. Stippling meaning we're going to make lots of little dots. And we're going to cluster them on one side to make it look darker, and then we'll space them out more on the other side to make it look lighter. So let's start on our tiny little baby mountain down here. I'm going to first just put dots everywhere, just tapping my pen lightly. You don't have to press hard. Don't ruin the tip of your pen. Just touch, 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 touch. Whoops, I'm not on camera very well. Touch, touch, touch. Then I come back and I add a second layer, but only to the bottom part. I don't go all the way to the top. I'm just doing the same thing, touch, 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 not all the way to the top. It's okay if you're not finished with the sky, that's easy to just fill in black on your own time. I'm gonna add more little dots right on my ocean line, sticking really, really close to my ocean line. Until it's almost solid black. Oh no, paper cut! That's one of the dangers of being an artist.
And blisters from holding a pencil too long.
Yes. That's why you gotta take care of your hands, your wrists, do your stretches, get band-aids for your paper cuts. This one over here is almost solid black. So that's gonna be a lot of dots all clustered together. Same thing on the other mountains. It's already time to share. What? I'll let you guys work another 2 minutes and then we'll go ahead and share. For the flippers, you can do the stippling too, or I'm going to do lines dot dot dot. Line dot dot dot. So it looks a little bit like the water, a little bit like the stippling. Like Morse code, just lines and dots. Dots and dashes. I'm going to do a little stippling on the tail too, but I'll have to do that on my own time because it is time to share already. Anybody who needs to take a picture, go ahead and take it right now. So I'm not going to be working on it anymore in class. Alrighty, who's ever ready to share, go ahead and hold it up to the camera so I can spotlight you for everybody. Oh, my light is blinding you guys probably, huh? There we go. Who's ready? Looks like Callista's ready. Let me spotlight for everybody. Just gotta fill in that black sky and it'll look beautiful. Oh, there's another beautiful one that just needs the black sky. You guys did great. Who else is ready to share? Looks like Kristen's ready. Let me spotlight for everyone. That's really
good.
I like
that one.
Let me see it again, Kristen. It was too fast.
My.
Wow. I like that. Lifting the tail, huh? Very nice.
I was tall. I didn't even realize it.
Let's go ahead and see who else is ready to share.
Tracy.
Looks like Tracy is. Let me spotlight for everybody. Woo!
Wow, you finished the sky.
Very nice.
No.
Who else is ready?
Natalie.
Nobody? Fousey. Natalie or Fousey? Oh, looks like Natalie's ready.
I'm almost done.
A little higher. Oh, yes.
I like that big sweeping tail.
I like that eye, too. That's a great eye.
That was a great eye.
He had kind of a looking up toward us look on him.
For sure. How about you, Fousey? You got 1 minute. Ooh, that's spotlight for everybody. Ooh,
oh, good work. Lovely.
I like those waves.
Oh, that's good.
Your sky, too. Wow.
Yeah, very nice job, everybody.
So that was a good solution for the tail, too. Just let it be part of the sky.
Just let it be part of the sky, yeah. That you can just color it in black if you prefer. Excellent. Well, I hope I'll see some of you guys on Friday. I'll let you have a sneak peek of what we're going to draw. Am I on camera? Let's see. Does it show up?
Oh, no.
Not really.
Wow. Okay.
Wow. I like it.
Friday.
Magical horse class. Ooh.
That's Friday.
Magical. Super magical.
Absolutely. Hope to see you guys on Friday.
And in your artwork.
Please send in your artwork.
In your artwork.
Bye.
I'm saying this for the art show. It's coming up. We need your artwork.
Please send in your artwork. Also, it's right on the website.